Okay, let me watch. Mars. Oops, I didn't start the recording. Now we're on. Let your arms fall to either side. And take this time, these first few moments in your shavasana, to get connected to breath. Long in through your nose. Long breath out. Good, Phil. And see. It's three. Two. One. Good. And you're going to bend your right knee up to your chest. Loop your fingers around. And then just take a couple moments. Circle your knee a little bit. You should feel this in your hip socket. Circle the other way. Keeping your low back down, can you straighten this leg and loop your fingers either behind the back of your thigh or the back of your shin? So I don't want you at your knee or behind your knee because you're working to keep your leg straight. And then if you want a little extra, you're working to pull your leg in closer, keeping it straight. Good, one. And with your left hand, you'll guide your right knee across, coming into a twist, and just find whatever, you might bend your knee at this point, find whatever allows you to keep both shoulders glued to the mat. Don't worry too much about where your foot or your knee end up. Awesome, that's one. Great, let's come to center and release this leg out. We'll go the other way. So we're gonna pull left knee to chest, hold on to the knee, and just start to circle in your hip socket. And circle the other way. We'll straighten our leg, we'll send it up to the air, and then loop your fingers either behind your thigh, behind your shin. Yeah, it can be passive and it can be active too. So you kind of do what you need here, working to keep your low back down. And then we'll hold on to our leg. We'll go to the other side, finding our twist. Try to keep left shoulder down. That's your priority. Where your knee, where your left leg end up is less important. Good, it's just one. Guys, I'm loving all your cameras on. I love to see you practicing with me. Feels less weird in this electronic age. Okay, take one. You'll come back to center. You're gonna bend both knees up and just rock up and down, okay? Take it slow. find a little hover each time you come to the top. And then when you're ready, you'll cross your ankles, you'll set your hands. I want you to take it to a child's pose. So feet together, knees wide, and then sink yourself down. Good. And from here, we're just gonna slide our right arm underneath, bring our right shoulder, right side of head down. Okay, right hand back, left arm under, left side of head to the mat. And just settle in. Awesome, take one. And then you're gonna bring your hands back. Okay, we're gonna push into our palms, we're gonna lift up. Then I want you to come from child's pose into a tricep push-up and then take it back to child's. Okay, so simple. From child's, we're shifting forward, we're taking a little push-up, elbows in close, and then we're going back. And do this a few times here. Let's do another three. Two. Take one. And then from your child, you're gonna come up to table. Get your shoulders over your wrist, your hips over your knees, and start to sway, start to circle. And it's up to you what you do next, okay? You can take cat-cow, you can warm up your wrists, you can warm up your shoulders, all right? Whatever your body needs. Your tabletop, and then we're gonna take it up and back. Just find a downward dog, and in your downward dog, you're gonna pedal out. So really good for you, stuff for your calves. You're gonna try to get your heels down to the mat one at a time. Okay, so one heel gets down, we pause there, the other heel lifts up, and then you switch from side to side. Go as slowly as you like. Couple more here. When you're done, you'll find stillness. You'll find a downward facing. Good. And then simple. We're gonna walk our feet all the way up to the top. When you get to the top, it's a forward fold. Okay, grabbing your opposite elbows, let your head hang. Keep a bend in your knees. Take two. It's one. Oh, no. All right, so listen up. We're gonna bring our hands down to start. I want you to bring your left hand right in front of your left toes, and then start to bend your left leg. As you do that, right arm goes up, right leg gets straight. Okay, so we're bending our left side. If this is too low for you, you might make a fist to get higher. You might use a prop under your left hand. Good, just breathe. That's the positive vibes and we create. Hold it. Awesome. Take one. And then we're going to bring our right hand down just for a pause. You're going to bend your right leg, send it back. And then you're finding it's a lunge. Your left hand is down, your right arm is lifted, your right leg is back. Okay, just breathe. Like the opposite of easy twist, okay? Right heel lifted. Take one. Stay with it. And then you'll bring your right hand down and find your easy twist. Left arm goes up. Okay, left arm goes up. We're turning our chest up to the left. Good, it's just two. Stay with it. Okay, it's one. You're gonna walk your hands now to the right, turn your toes that way, and find a wide legged hold. Funny story for you guys. I was practicing yesterday morning and I realized I did the entire class with my left and my right mixed up because that's how I teach, right? I teach every time I say right side, it's my left. And I think like I've permanently caused damage there. I don't think I know left and right as intuitively as everyone else, okay? Hold your wide legged fold. And then from here, guys, we're gonna bring our hands just under our shoulders. We're gonna make little pyramids with our hands and you're gonna take a little bend from side to side. Okay, a little bend from side to side. Soothingly, she tell me if it turn up the sound. Have you ever been in love? Now bad vibes can't awesome. Stop. It's just two. Good vibration, yeah. Keep pushing through your heels. Yeah. That's the positive vibes and creating, yeah. Sounds that make you feel. Okay, let's crawl it to the top. We're gonna square our shoulders, square our hips, and then take your left leg back. It's a high plank to low. Okay, knees can drop if you want. Chest comes through. Hey, Tanya. Forever shining this. Send it back. Ooh, yeah. And then pedal out again. Get it, two. One. And then simple, you're gonna walk your hands up. You're gonna take another forward fold. This time, if you want a little more, you're gonna wrap your arms behind your shins and then pull yourself. So with my arms, I'm like pulling myself down lower. Again, knees are bent here. You don't have to worry about keeping legs straight. Just breathe. Good, stay low. Awesome, we have two. One. All right, so we'll undo. We're doing the other side. So right hand comes in front of right toes. You're gonna bend your right knee. You're gonna straighten your left leg and take your left arm up in the air. Okay, leaning into the right side. If that's too low, use a prop under your right hand, guys. So one leg is bent, one leg is straight. Awesome. Stay with it. Good, it's one. Okay, so with my left hand, I'm just coming down for a little pause. I'm sending my left leg behind into a high lunge, and then I'm staying in this shape. So left arm reaches up. It's tricky. Left arm reaches up. You're gonna look up over left shoulder, try to find balance. Good, it's just one. Keep that back heel stacked over your ankle. I have a mirror in front of me and I just noticed mine is really off. Okay, you're gonna switch, it's easy twist. So left hand down, right arm lifts. Good, hold it. Stay here, back heel is stacked right over your toes. Good, just one. Okay, hands down, crawl it to the left, find your wide-legged fold. Same thing, if you want this one to be a little bit more intense, hands can go behind your ankles. You use that to pull yourself lower. You don't have to do that. Wherever you are though, keep your legs straight. Try to keep your hips square. Good, and then you're gonna bring your hands just under your shoulders, same thing. We're gonna bend from side to side, leaning into each heel as you go. Chest is lifted. Keep it going. Awesome, guys, for two. One. Okay, crawl it to the top, square shoulders, square hips. It's a high plank to low. Chest through. Awesome, downward dog. Big breath here. And slowly empty. Up to toes, bend your knees, step walk or hop. All right, let's flow. It's halfway lift. Fold and empty. Rise all the way up. Arms come down. Reach up, look up. Palms together, let's fold. Good, flat back. Hands to your mat, it's high plank to low. Chest through. Good, push it back. Right away, to your toes. Bend your knees, step walk or hop. Halfway. Good, fold. Follow me, reach up all the way. Arms come down. This time we'll sit low. Good, hands to your mat. Right foot stays, left foot steps. I want you to find a high lunge right away. Arms reach up. Awesome, just breathe. Big breath. As you exhale, hinge it. And I want you to hold. I know we usually do this one as a flow. I want you to just hold it. Stay low. A lot for two. Keep the bend in your right leg. One. All right, easy twist. Left hand down, right arm reaches up. Beautiful. Hold. Stay and look up. One. Okay, follow me, guys. We're gonna take Skandasana to the mat. Okay, take Skandasana to the back of your mat, so over to that left leg, okay? And then wherever you are, we're gonna do three little switches. So you're either up here or you're all the way down in Skandasana, okay? Hands can help you or they can't, or they don't have to. For one, you're gonna go to the top, switch Skandasana. Okay, to the back, switch Skandasana. Beautiful, to the top, switch it. Okay, once more, to the back, switch it. Good, just hold at the back. Stay with it. Two. Okay, one. All right, now crawl it to the top and then just flow, high plank to low. Chest comes through. Good, send it back. Hold it or flow, it's a right side, left side. Or you're holding your downward dog, okay, whatever you need. If you're flowing with me, it's right side, warrior one. Hands to the mat, we flow. Good, and then left side, warrior one, you rise up. Beautiful, hands to your mat, high to low. Push it back. Take a breath in, down dog. And slowly empty. Okay, two arched toes. Bend your knees, step walk or hop. Flat back. Bow your chest. Rise up. Beautiful, arms down. Reach up, look up. Awesome, eyes fold forward. Halfway, breathe in. High to low plank as you breathe out. Okay, knees can drop at any point. Press through. Good, down dog. Right away to your toes. Bend your knees, step walk or hop. Halfway. Good, bow. Rise up. Arms along. Now you'll sit. Okay, with your bum low, left hands come down, left foot stays, right foot steps, you take your high lunge. Good, just breathe. Hips are square, back leg is straight. Okay, it's one. And then we'll lean, arms come along our sides. This one's like way harder to hold, okay? Just try. Whew. Good, we have two. Stay. One. Okay, lean forward a little more. Right hand down, left arm up. Find your easy twist. Chest to the sky. Back leg is straight, back heel is still stacked. We've got one. Okay, then I want you to crawl it to the back. It's Dandasana. Three switches. So let's start at the back. Hand or no hands. I want you to switch to the top. This is one. Okay, switch to the back. This is two. Switch to the top. This is three. Huh, I guess it's actually four. Can't count either. Okay, back to the back. Then you're gonna settle in. All right, you're gonna settle in at the back. Good, stay with me. Two. You got it. And if that's too much, guys, do what we did at the beginning with the wide-legged fold and going side to side. All right, it's one. Okay, let's crawl it to the top. Just flow, high plank to low. As comes through. Good, it's a downward dog. You're gonna hold for five or you're gonna flow. It's left side, warrior one, let's rise. Beautiful, hands down, we flow. Yes, Steph, so good. Flow it back. And then it's right side, warrior one, rise up. Plant your hands and flow. Good, downward dog, and then let's all take a breath together. Slowly empty. All right, to your toes. Bend your knees, step walk or hop. Flat back. Bow your chest. Okay, from the top, arms come up. Arms fall. Reach up, look up, fold forward. Halfway, high to low plank. Pass through. Good, downward facing. Right away to your toes. Bend your knees, step walk or hop. Good, just bow. Let's rise. Arms come down. Sit low. Let your hands help you. So hands come down, right foot stays, left foot steps. It's a high lunge to start. good. Hold. Square your hips, square your shoulders. Big breath. Let's lean. Let's go to the chest forward. And then guys, what I want you to do is interlace your fingers together if you can. If you can't, just keep them apart. It's a little bend in our left. We're gonna kick off to warrior three. Yeah, find it, it's tricky. Interlace fingers. Good, for two. Stay with me. For one. Okay, just step it back. Uncross, hands crawl. To the back, it's Skandasana one, let's go. Two. Good, three, this is our three, we'll stop here. Get low in Skandasana, just pause. You can always work on a bind here at the back, left arm in front, right arm behind. Good, for two. For one. All right, let's call it to the top. Guys, I want you to square your shoulders, square your hips, and then I want you to find a long pyramid. So it's basically turning your back toes in a little bit. Heel might have to go out. Legs straight, legs back. And then we hinge. We hinge over the front leg. Props are a great tool as you try to keep your legs straight. So your back foot is not in line with your front. If it is, you're not gonna be able to balance, okay? It's out a little bit. Hips square. Awesome, just one. Stay here, empty. And then I want you to just bend that back knee, bring it down. Thumbs together, fingers wide. Let's come into a lizard, okay? Come into lizard pose, hug your knee in. Good, just breathe. Stay low. And then if you want a little more, we're gonna take it to winged dragon. So right foot comes out to the edge of your mat, come to the outside edge of your right foot. Left knee might go back a little bit. And then maybe there's space to come lower. And the add from here, if you're in winged dragon, is right hand to knee, pushing away, or going for the bind. Bending your left foot, going for your left foot with your right hand. Whew. Just breathe. Good, stay. Three. Two. One. Okay, from winged dragon, just bring your back foot down. You'll bring your right foot back in. And then when you're ready, step it back to plank. It's a high to low. Good, push it back. Right side, left side, or you hold it. This is our last flow, okay? Right foot steps. Warrior one to rise. Good, hands down, you flow. And do the left side, warrior one. Good, hands down. Take a breath at the back. And slowly empty. Okay, come to the toes, your toes, bend your knees. Step, walk, or hop. Flat back. Good, fold it forward. From the top, let's rise up. Arms along your sides. Reach up, look up. hands touch you fold.
Halfway lift.
Blow it back. Right away, guys, to your toes. Bend your knees, step walk or hop. Halfway. Good, fold. Let's rise. Arms come down. Okay, sit low. Hands will help you. Hands come down, left foot stays, right foot steps. It's a high lunge, rise. Hips square, shoulders square. Get high on your back heel. Good, you're gonna lean. Lean forward, arms to sides. Okay, so we're gonna try, if you're binding, guys, try to keep your wrists together when you bind. There's a little lift, a little bend in the right knee. You come up, it's warrior three. It requires a lot of focus, okay? We're not doing much balancing today. That always makes that harder. Take two. Good, stay lifted. Take one. And then with control, you'll start to bend your left leg. You'll land your right foot down. We'll undo, okay? Crawl to the back. Skandasana one, get low. Good, Skandasana two, get low. Skandasana three, get low, hold it. Maybe you bind. Good, breathe. Two. Stay with me. All right, it's one. Okay, pushing into our hands. Let's crawl it to the top. I want you to find that wide, that long triangle pose. So you're probably gonna have to walk your right foot out a little bit. And then you're gonna really work on straightening both legs. Take your hips back. If you need to come up and set up, that's fine, okay? And then from here, we hinge. Just breathe. Try to keep legs straight. So if it's too much, it's a lot, okay? If it's too much, you're using a prop. Good, two. One. Bend your right knee, bring it down. Let's start in lizard, thumbs together, fingers wide. At the instep of your left, hug your knee in. If you want to move on, it's winged dragon. So we're gonna walk our left foot to the edge of our mat. I like to send my right knee back a little further. And then maybe there's space to get low. If you want to push your knee out, if you want to bend and go for your back foot, you can do that now. And then simple, you'll bring your hands back. You'll crawl your foot back in if need be. I know it's not the smoothest transition. We're gonna make our way to our plank and we're gonna flow. Good. You stay or you take a left side, right side. It's our last one. Right. right foot steps. Rise up. And then simple, take a breath at the back. Exhale all the way. I want you to bring your knees back to the mat, take them wide. Bring your heels close. You're gonna come into child's pose again. I like to do this one a little more active, so I'm gonna show you maybe from the side. So my heels are lifted, and I'm gonna make two fists with my hands, stacking them. I'll bring my forehead down. And just let yourself melt down towards your hands. If you want to massage out your head a little bit, do that. Moving from side to side. Awesome. When you're ready, I want you to sit up. Okay, so we're just gonna, from here, we're gonna sit back. So untuck your toes, cross your ankles, have a seat. Wow, my words today are lost on me. You're gonna come to Baddha Konasana to start, feet together. Just flutter out. From here, I'm gonna straighten out my left leg in front, and then I'm gonna pick up my right. I'm gonna bring it on top. So making a figure four here with your right leg on top. Both feet are really active, okay? Easier version, one hand to knee, one hand to heel, just sit tall. More challenging is to start to lean forward. Oof. Really challenging is to go for your foot, your extended foot. Wherever you are, both feet stay active. Good, too. One. Okay, sit up, and then can you bend your left leg, push into your hands, and just come forward a little bit? Okay, so pull your hips forward, and then extend your left leg again. We're coming into a seated thread the needle. Okay, so seated thread the needle, just pushing your right knee away, little tiny hip opener for your right. Okay, we're gonna undo and then do the right side. So let's start with the seated thread the needle. I mean on the left side. Oh guys, so sorry. So left leg is on top, right leg is long, and then you're in seated thread the needle, pushing. So if you just sit up, you're gonna get a little bit of hip opening. If you want more, you're pushing and applying some pressure to your left knee. Keep your top foot flexed. Awesome, one more. And then we'll straighten our right leg. We'll come into the figure four on the left. So really good. Start by flexing both your feet, really active. One hand to heel, one hand to knee. You can sit upright. You can start to lean forward. Ooh. If you you want the full stretch, you're gonna start to go for your right foot. One. Let's come up. Let's undo. Hopefully you have enough room to lie back. Okay, I want you to grab the backs of your knees, lie back, and take your legs up into the air. Okay, coming into your inversion, shoulders, low back are grounded as your legs go up. And we're working to stack our heels over our knees. Stack our knees over our hips. If you want to add your arms, you can take those up as well. There's no rush. You have a few minutes here. I want you to stay until you feel like the cold, the tingly sensations in your extremities. And then you might slowly start to bend your knees, let your feet dangle. Let your arms fall. Take your final resting pose. You've landed, be still. We don't have much time here. I want you to make the most of it. Start to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes. And reach your arms overhead. Take a full body stretch. And just roll into the fetal position on one side. And with your eyes closed, find a seat at the top of your mat. Palms together at your heart center. Take a big breath in through your nose. Open your mouth and sigh. Do it again, fill up. Thumbs to your forehead center. Namaste. Thank you. Thanks so much. Let me know how you feel.